is six people who get stuck in a New York City subway. I'm from New York. I ride the subway all the time. As soon as I heard that, I went, I'm in. It was a play originally, a musical play that was written by a guy named Riley Thomas, who's here tonight. And he told a friend of his told me about it. He told me that was what it was. And I said, I want to direct that. And so I read it, and thank God it was good. And we developed it, and we produced it first at a festival called the Nymph New York Music Theater Festival. We put it up on stage. It was very successful at the festival. It was supposed to have some subsequent productions, but it turned out that we started making the film instead, because I told a producer that I said, this would make an unbelievable film. It's about six people. It's, you know, confined to a subway. And it's about these six completely different people, become, you know, the different ages, different backgrounds, different races, everything. And we locked them in a subway, and they all had to just sort of figure it out. Everyone is so angry about everything. And this is a film about how these six people sort of healed each other for a couple hours or a minute or maybe the next day, and how they really do connect, and how they even connect in their real lives and don't even really know it. As soon as Giancarlo's name came up, I knew who he was, because from being a Breaking Bad fan, I knew who he was from that, from his character Gus Fring in Breaking Bad. He was exactly what I wanted, because he was a man with real gravitas, real elegance, real threat. And all of those aspects needed to be in Lloyd. And also, you can even see it in Gus Fring. He has this great love that he comes with as well. And all those virtues he brings to the screen. And you'll see, as one can see in the film, whenever anything is going on in the train, I would cut to Giancarlo. And after a while, my editors are like, why do we keep cutting to him? I said, because this is through his eyes. His character hears their music. And I needed this actor to do that. And once we started discussing Giancarlo, he was the only one that I wanted. Because what he brings to it, his strength and majesty and humility, frankly, that he brings to this character, is exactly the human that I wanted in that role. Here's the thing is that this is not the kind of musical where we go da-da-da-da-da-da and the song starts. My goal has always been, and the musicals that I've worked on in my theater life have always been musicals where songs become extensions of the dialogue that help to illuminate the character more. And if those songs don't push the story along, I don't want them in the movie. So it's never about, this is going to be a fun, cute song here. It's always going to be an extension of the dialogue. And I hope and I venture to say that after a while, you start to forget that they're launching into song, that it just becomes part of the story. That's my hope. It was a challenge to shoot in one location. We do get out of the subway and go see, you know, various locations in and around New York City. But the bulk of the movie was shot in a set that we built in the Pfizer building that was an exact replica of the train that we were on. And what I found is that because it was in this big, dark, cavernous space, that tends to affect a crew and a cast in a great deal, because my previous movie, we got to shoot outdoors for almost the whole thing, and it was a completely different experience. I had a great crew. I had a great cast, and they stood up to the challenge. But being in that dark space was perfection for the movie, because it's exactly the mood, exactly the feel of what it was like to be trapped on a subway car, which I have been trapped on a subway car in New York City many times myself. So it was a blessing and a curse. It made for a difficult shoot, but it was the exact right thing for this movie. Festivals like this that Elliot has been running, and the opportunity to show the film in this kind of a venue, and the way that he highlights, the way that he pushes the films, the way that his entire company and crew push the films, is exactly what independent filmmakers like me need, because we don't necessarily have a whole team of people working to get our work out. And we make these films for people to see. Of course, we make them because we want to tell our stories, and we're lucky enough to be storytellers, but we're storytellers because we have to be, because we want to be. And to have someone that just believes in the films and wants to help us get these stories out, I can't really express how much it means to myself, and I venture to say the other filmmakers here, to be shown in this kind of a venue. I hope it leaves them with a little bit of lift, and I hope that it reminds them that everyone is someone's brother, someone's son, someone's mother, someone's father, someone's uncle. And the person that's waiting on you at a restaurant, the person that you're sitting across from the subway, the person that you're trying to get by in the huge crowd is somebody with a story. And that they're not just in your way. They're not just serving you. That they have wants, desires, dreams, hopes, hurts, and all that. And I'm not trying to be cheesy about it. That's really what this movie is about. And in those moments, how a stranger can change your life.